Greetings and salutations, and welcome to the Content Tree interface. Content trees are a shiny, shiny new world-building feature, as of the recording date of this video, that helps you display and organize your world-building content in different kinds of tree structures. I'm Janet from World Anvil, and in this video, I'm going to get you started with content trees. Are you ready? It's time to light up the forge. So, let's start by talking about what content trees are. Content trees are a way to create tree structures of your content. Now, these can be injected into any location on the World Anvil platform using a World Anvil tag. Unlike the automatically generated article trees, these content trees can include any kind of article. At the time of recording, you can only add articles to these trees, but later on, we might be adding other kinds of content, like timelines, maps, and categories. So if you want this, then please let me know in the comments below. So let's get started. I'm going to show you how to make one. Content trees are part of the new charts toolset on the website. You can find that by going to the chart section here in the left-hand menu bar underneath your world. Or you can use the green hammer button. Remember, you can swap worlds in the green hammer button too. And of course, you can jump there really quickly using the Artemis navigation system. Use Control Enter to open the Artemis panel, then type Create Content Tree, or just Con will get you there, to create a new content tree. From the charts interface, click Create a New Content Tree to get started. Give it a name and a description, choose its status as public or private, and choose subscriber groups who can see it. Those outside of those subscriber groups will not see the tree if it's private. And then create your tree. You can now see the Content Tree Edit interface. Your tree will display here on the left, and you can use this panel on the right to add content to your tree. In Settings, you can change the basic information about your content tree, and also delete your tree. But only do that if you're certain, because when it's gone, it's gone. Let's start by adding some content to your content tree. Start by selecting an article from the drop-down menu. All of your articles will appear in this list: draft and published articles, public and private articles. And the article will display as an item on the content tree regardless of its public, private, or draft status. However, as normal, no one will be able to access and read articles which they don't have permissions for. If you want to, select a parent for your article. If you don't select a parent, it will appear on the top level of the tree, but you can drag and drop it into position. Then click Save Changes, and the article will appear on your content tree on the left. Now you've done that, let's check out the Advanced Options section. You can choose for your selected article to display with a different title in the tree. You might choose to do this if your real title is a spoiler, or if you're using a different naming system within the content tree for clarity. If your selected article has an excerpt, which you can add under the Design tab of each article, it will automatically be shown as the description of the item on the content tree. But if you prefer, you can add a description here, which will show on the content tree and override the original excerpt if one is present. Ordinarily, the article's cover image will show on the content tree when it's displayed, but you can select a different image if you want to. Remember, the blue button is the fastest way to upload new images, but you'll need to refresh the page for the new image to appear in the dropdown. If you have a public content tree, but you'd like to make some items in it private, you can set that in the Advanced Options here. If you set an item as private, any child items beneath that item will also be invisible on the tree for those without access. You can give subscriber-only access to private items, which means that only chosen players, readers, customers, or your Patreons and superfans will be able to see them. Learn more about this in the Access Rights tutorial, linked in the description. You can also create items on trees which have no article attached to them. These might be placeholders for articles you want to write later, or just visualizations of aspects of your world which don't need articles for some reason. To do this, simply don't select an article. You will have to add a title though under Advanced Options. Fill in the rest of the form as normal and click Save Changes. Now you know how to add items one by one, let's talk about adding multiple items at once. Hey! Go to the Add Multiple Items tab, input a tag, and click Add Articles. All the articles with this tag will be added to the table en masse. You can then drag and drop the articles into position within the tree. By the way, tags are going to become increasingly important in World Anvil for organizing your world building. You can add tags in an article under the Navigation tab, but the quickest way is in the Explorer, using the Quick Edit feature. Now, let's take a look at your tree. You can drag and drop items to rearrange them in your content tree. When you drag a parent item, all its child items will come with it automatically. If a content item is private on the tree, it'll show a padlock like this. That item and anything beneath it will not show to those without permissions. You can expand or collapse the children of an item by clicking this bookmark icon. If an item has an added description, the ellipses icon will show, and you can mouse over it to see the description. Click the Edit button to edit any item of content in the content tree. The options here are the same as the Creation interface and the Advanced options, and you can also delete an item from your content tree here. Just a few extra tips for making content trees. Each item can only have one parent, but it can have multiple children. Content can appear more than once in a tree, if you want it to. For example, you might have a character who holds more than one title in an organization, or a spell that belongs to more than one school of magic. Use the purple button! I'm serious, the purple button, people. This will help you create content on the fly to fill out your tree. Remember, once you've created articles with the purple button, you'll need to refresh the page so they appear in the drop-down menus. And finally, you can create several heads, that is, top-level items of a tree, which have their own structures. Just be aware that the bigger your tree gets, the more complex and confusing it can be for your readers. Remember, you can always just create another content tree for the secondary thread if you want to. You can make as many of these bad boys as you want to. Now you've created your content tree, let's talk about how you can display it. There are three ways you can display your content tree: as a textual chart, as a static chart, or as an interactive chart. In a textual chart, the article titles are displayed as texts with links, and the description, when present, is displayed beneath each. If you've edited your content, the titles and descriptions you've added will appear. This textual chart is a great way to display your content tree in a linear fashion, and it can be excellent as an alternative navigation or table of contents for a section of your world building. A great place to put this might be the sidebar section of an article to help people navigate within the hierarchy that you've created. In a static chart, the content will appear in a simple tree-like structure without any imagery. You can mouse over each item to read the description. These static charts are very useful as a clear navigation tree of your content. They're plain, simple, and easy to understand. If your chart is very wide, you can scroll through it, but you might want to consider the final kind of display, interactive charts. In interactive charts, the content appears in an interactive tree, with the set image as the background of each content item. The title and description is visible over the image, and if you mouse over, the description expands to cover the full panel. These interactive charts are draggable to help you navigate through them. You can also zoom in and out of these using the scroll function on the panel. And there's a search for interactive charts. This makes it easy to find what you're looking for, even if the chart is very large. In addition, you can collapse or expand sections by clicking the small minus sign on the top right-hand corner of an item. Interactive charts are excellent for very big structures which require navigation to explore. Embedding any of these kinds of trees is incredibly simple. Clicking the button here on the Edit interface will copy the World Anvil tag to your clipboard. Then you can just paste the tag into any text field you like, and it's that easy. So now you know how to use content trees, you know how to make them, you know how to put them in your world, let's talk about what you can use them for. Content trees are incredibly flexible, and they can be used for pretty much whatever you want, but they are ideal for showing systems, hierarchies, and structures. Here are some of our ideas about how you can use them. They're great for showing the hierarchy of your country structure with its rulers as well, or for the organization of hierarchies like secret societies, militaries, or anything else. You can also use them for things like orders of battle, to show troops and ranking. Or how about using a content tree to show your magic system, using magical schools and showing the spells within them. You could use content trees to show vehicles and classes of vehicles within a fleet, and even include their manufacturers. Or how about inventors and their technological development, or a straight up technology tree. And finally, content trees would be a great way to show lines of monarchs or lines of rulers. So what are you going to use content trees for? And what else would you like to see for this feature? Let me know in the comments below, and if somehow you're not on World Anvil, go to worldanvil.com right now to get started. If you found this video helpful, or if it's made you think, then please give us a thumbs up and get more World Anvil tips and tutorials, plus inspiring world building content, by subscribing and clicking the bell. Ting! Now grab your hammer and go world build!